creep up towards our heels. Big toe mounds are together. Forehead either goes to the mat or a block. Taking a big breath in. And exhaling it out. Again, breathing in. And exhaling it out. Gently bring yourself up to find tabletop. Bring those knees underneath those hips. Hands underneath those shoulders. Start to find your cat-cow rounding through. And exhale and find your cow. Good, again, rounding through. Tailbone and chin tucks. Press to the earth. Exhale, find your cow. Lift your tailbone and your chin. One more time, rounding through. As you're at the top, go ahead and just push your hips left to right. And then find center, belly pulls in. Walk those hands forward, find melting heart. Tailbone stays up as you open through those shoulders, underneath those armpits, forehead or chin comes to the mat. Breathing here. Bring your big toe mounds back together. Hips go back to those heels again. Walk those hands forward for child's pose once again. Walk your hands over to the left side of the mat, finding a side body stretch. Bring it back to center. Lift your chest, bring your knees in, sit back on those heels, finding modified hero's pose, sitting nice and tall, breathing for a moment. And you can even bring your hands behind your back today, opening through the chest, lifting the chin. Pull that belly in, breathe here. Forward. head and we stay up, and we're gonna bring our left foot forward to find a low lunge. Inhale, lift those hands high to the sky. Roll those shoulders away from the ears, pull the belly in. Act like you're dragging that back knee to that front heel and that front heel to the back knee. Like you're wrinkling that mat. Good, bring your hands back to heart center. Shift your hips back if they lean forward. Pick up your left foot and bring it to the side, toe pointed out. Good. Here we're just gonna move the hips a little bit. So we're gonna exhale, lean towards that knee, inner thigh, and bring it back. Now I want you to just tuck that hip down and under to the back and bring it back to center. Good. Exhale, bring it out. Bring it back. Tuck. And back. One more time. Out. Bring it center and tuck. Good. Bring it back to center. Lift the foot back up to find your low lunge. Inhale, lift again. Exhale, bring those hands behind the back. Open up to the chest, chest opener here. Good, bring the hips back. Bring the hands to heart center. Exhale, bring that heel forward, finding hamstring stretch. Blocks are welcome here on either side if needed. Pull that front hip down, don't let it lift. Maybe actively drag that heel into the mat just a little bit. Breathing, long spine. Good, inhale through the chest. Bring the hands back to heart. Place that foot back to low lunge. Hold for a moment, and then bring that knee back down and under. Good, we're gonna find it on the other side. Right foot's gonna come forward. Inhale, lift to low lunge, breathing. Draw that front heel to the back knee to the front heel. Good, bring the hips back, hands come to heart. Lift that foot up and we bring it to the side. Good, right here, we're gonna lean into it, exhale. Inhale, bring it back, keep that hip down and under. Bring it back to center. Exhale, bring it out. Inhale, bring it back. Kink, lift. One more time, exhale. Bring it back. Find that little hip, bring it back. Good. Bring that foot back to the front. Inhale, lift. Exhale, bring the hands behind, opening up through the chest. Breathing here. Good. Bring the hips back. Lifting up, finding your heel to come forward. Hamstring stretch. Draw that heel back into that mat. Slightly breathing, lengthening through the spine instead of curling. Good, inhale, lift back up. Find it for just a moment. Bring that knee back down and under. Good, bring the palms down. Tuck your toe, press back, find bound up. Pedal up those heels. Maybe even shift your hips left to right. Just finding movement. Good, then walk your hands back to your feet. Forward folding at the back edge of the mat. Knees are bent, chest is against those thighs. Release the head, look through those knees as much as possible. Then take note of your feet. Notice all four corners of those feet should be on the ground. Maybe we're just slightly activating a pull between those heels to set the pelvis into place. Like there's a magnet there. Good, here we're gonna inhale, halfway lift, bringing our hands to our shins. Exhale, forward fold. Hands come back to heart center, butt lower as we lift up strong through those legs. Big inhale. Exhale, hands down to the chest. Inhale the hands, steeple grip. Keep those shoulders stacked as we lean to the left side. Big breath. Lift instead of crash. Good, bring it back to center. Other side. Good, bring it back to center. Hands come through heart. We find our first seat, Utkatasana, bringing our butt back. Chin is lifted. Pull that belly in. Wiggle the toes just a little bit and breathe. Good, inhale, lift. Exhale, forward fold. Pause and breathe again. Magnet between those heels. Walk your feet forward. Find a strong plank. If knees need to drop for modification, they can lower. Otherwise, stay strong through that plank, breathing. Lowering through chaturanga all the way to the floor. Untucking those toes, walking the forearms forward, bring the elbows next to the chest, turn the palms down as much as possible. Squeeze to the belly, lifting up to find Sphinx. Pull the shoulders away from those ears. Squeeze through the butt to protect the low back. Good, gently release. Bring those palms forward, reaching in front of you. Lock the tops of the feet down on the mat. Pull the belly in, squeeze through the butt. Inhale, lift those hands off the floor. Breathing and reaching. Feet stay down, hold. Don't hold the breath. Good, gently release. Bring those hands back next to the chest. Inch from your left knee in and then your right. And press yourself up using those arms. Tuck your toes, press back, find down dog. Reset those hands if you need to. Take a couple breaths here, just really feel yourself lengthening. Walk your feet to the front of the room. Forward fold. This time, if you'd like to ragdoll those arms by bringing the hands into the crooks of the elbows and hanging, you can. Knees are still bent, protecting the back and those hamstrings. Good. As you roll up, I want you to keep your hands in the ragdoll position, but lift the arms over the head as you roll. So tuck the tailbone through the spine, all the way up. And maybe you need to shift the hands on top of those elbows. Finding a tall spine, belly pulls in. Exhale over to the left side. Nice side body stretch again. Good, bring it back to center. Other side. Inhale those hands, bring them back to heart. Gently press the thumb against the sternum and take two breaths. Big inhale, exhale. Good again, inhale. And exhale. Good, lift those hands up as you inhale. Step your left foot back, find warrior one. Setting your hips to the front of the room as much as possible. Reaching those hands and relaxing the shoulders. Strong here. Squeezing those inner thighs and breathing. Good. Taking that back heel and turning it up. And then lowering the knee to find high lunge. Tuck the tailbone. towards center. Inhale and straighten that front leg and just tap that back toe. Now, I want you to just start to bring yourself forward in a warrior three. Lifting that back heel, palms are pressing strong. Hold and breathe. Down to those toes. We're not just hanging out, we're actively working inner thighs, belly, arms, legs. Spread the feet and breathe. Good. Turn that back heel up. Melt down. Lift with the spine, pull the belly in, high lunge. Gently lower the foot, bring the hand back into alignment. Here, you can just drop your right knee, lift your left, walk your right hand into center, bring your left hand high, stacking onto the other side, lifting that outer leg, toes facing forward, breathe. Gently lower down, bring that hand back to center, lower your knees, bring yourself back into tabletop, and round through that spine, find that angry cat again. Take a couple breaths here and really press to the earth. Exhale, find that cow. Palms are pressing. Find neutral, belly pulls in. Again, we're gonna lift that right hand all the way up to the sky, big twist like the beginning. But this time we're gonna exhale and thread that arm through, finding the shoulder. Good, gently bring yourself back up to tabletop. Finding it on the other side. Left hand's gonna reach to the sky. And we're gonna exhale, thread it all the way through shoulder, ear, breathing. Good, gently release, bringing yourself back up to tabletop. Inhale, lift those hips high to the sky. Our first three-legged dog, we lift our right heel high, pinky toe turned down. Here, I want you to make your way through to find your knee to the front of the mat, finding low lunge. Pause if you can to breathe through that core. Exhale, lower the foot down, lower the knee. Inhale and lift again. Exhale, lower the left hand across the outside of that right thigh and reach the right hand back. Nice spinal twist. Maybe you gaze over that back thumb. Inhale, lift those hands up. Exhale, bring the hands inside to find lizard. Now today, instead of really working that foot out, rotating to the pinky edge, I want you to plant your hands to blocks or the mat, and then I want you to take your outside of your shoulder and press your inner thigh into it. So it's actively pressing shoulder into thigh, thigh into shoulder. Feel it work the legs, spine, and the abs. Good, release the press, tuck your toe, find your way back to down dog, setting yourself back up in that down dog, pedal up the feet, and when you're ready, inhale, left that left foot high, pinky toe turned down. Breathing. Pull the knee all the way through. Pause if you can in core. Exhale, lower the foot down. Bring the knee to the floor. Inhale, lift. Finding low lunge. Good. Active between those feet. Breathing. And then exhale and find that twist on the opposite side. Left hand goes back, right hand across the thigh. Reaching to the back wall, gazing over those back fingers, breathing. Inhale, bring it back to low lunge. Exhale, bring the hands inside, finding lizard. Spread the feet, or I should say the toes, and then press the inside of that thigh into that shoulder and the shoulder into the thigh. Release the hands down, press your left ear to the floor. Just finding a neck turn, rotation a little bit. Lift the chin, find the other side. Bring it back to center. Bring those hands back beside you, palms down. Find locus, lifting strong. Feet and chest squeezing together behind you. Sorry, feet and fingertips squeezing behind you. Chest lifts. Make sure you're not holding that breath. Gently release. Hands come next to the chest. Pull one knee in and then the other and press back up. Big toe mounds come together. Walk those hands forward. One final child's pose. Maybe roll the head left and right on the mat, giving yourself a little bit of a head massage. Calming the parasympathetic nervous system with the pressure of the mat. And your breath. Gently bring yourself all the way up, bringing your feet to the front of the room. Scooting yourself up for staff. Pull the flesh from underneath the sit bones. Sitting nice and tall. Take a big inhale, growing taller in the spine. Pull the shoulders away from the ears. Exhale, find an hinge, warming the belly. Stay strong. Watch those feet. Are they towards the ceiling? We've got nice, strong legs. Inhale and lift. Exhale. We're not totally forward folding. Sitting, we're reaching to the corner of the room. Flat back. Breathing here. Chest is coming forward instead of rounding forward. Breathe. Good. Inhale and lift. This time, I want you to maybe kink those toes together a little bit. Belly pulls in. Exhale and find that little bit of a hinge again. Staying warm through the core. Breathing. Active toes towards each other. Good. Inhale. We're going to try this hinge right here. Toes are still towards each other. Exhale. Reach those fingertips across the room. Flat back as you can. It'll be harder to reach this. Good, lifting back up, bring your hands to heart center, soles of the feet are going to come together, finding mountain angle. Actively press the soles of those feet together as you sit tall. Feel the abs start to work. I'm pressing here. Soles at about 20%. And then release the press, bring the hands down, let those knees open a little bit more. Find any movement you might need in the spine. Good. Inhale and bring those feet forward. Knees are bent in a modified boat pose. Hands are going to come to heart center again. You're going to lift your left leg to the sky. And then you're going to take your right elbow and you're going to try and tap it against that knee, pressing into that knee and the knee into that elbow. Lift that back elbow also. Stay strong through those arms. Gently lower, come back to center. Find that same thing on the other side. If the elbow doesn't reach, it's okay. We're just trying to find that twist in the active belly. If it does, gently press them against each other and breathe. Good. Unwind. Lower that foot. Once again, find bound ankle. Lifting. Let's bring the heels forward as wide as the mat. Our only forward fold here. You're going to inhale. Lift those hands up. Exhale. Reach as long as you can. And then find your shins or toes or ankles. Finding a full forward fold. Wider legs. Breathing. Good. heels forward, slowly lower yourself down to the floor. Taking your time using the core, palms come forward, exhale and slowly breathe. Rolling through that spine, staying active with each little bit of lowering. Use your breath to help. Good, all the way to the floor, reach those fingertips behind you, maybe point the toes. Take an inhale, bring your feet in towards the butt, bring your hands towards your thighs. Walk the feet in, and then spread all four corners of the feet onto the floor. Hands are down by the thighs, facing palm down. Gentle press into the earth as you inhale and lift those hips to the sky. Bridge. Gently bring the knees back up to center and find it on the other side. Passive twist on the other side. Maybe the gaze goes over the opposite fingertips. Breathing. Bringing it back to center, knees lifting. And then I want you to exhale and bring your right foot out and your left knee into the chest. Grabbing around that shin, maybe bringing your forehead to that knee. Flex both feet. Good, now keep this beautiful crunch and then switch. So the other knee comes in, the other foot goes out. Now heels can touch the ground or stay hovering for a little bit more work. So you can lift that left heel off. And here we're gonna switch four times. So switch, switch. Here's three, here's four. Good, bring it back to the other knee. Exhale the chest and then bring the heel to the sky, grabbing behind the thigh. No strap, just breathing here. Gently release and find the other side, finding that little bit of a hamstring stretch. Good. that foot down, finding the soles of the feet together, knees open, belly lets itself fall into the earth or the mat. Hands can go on those hips for just a moment. Big inhale and an exhale.
Namaste.